Hey, John Sonmez from simpleprogrammer.com. So I got a question. I've been getting asked this a lot, so I'm finally going to answer this, right? I'll probably do a blog post at some point on this as well. But I always mention this idea of side projects. And so I get a lot of questions on how to create one or, you know, how to pick one. I personally, it seems obvious to me, like, you know, don't mean to insult you, but it's worth talking about. So Michael sent me this email, and I've gotten a lot of emails about this. So Michael, you're not alone by any means. And he said, do you have a method or technique for brainstorming ideas for personal side projects? I'm not looking for actual project ideas, rather a way of coming up with ideas that people might want and develop these into potential money-earning ideas that I can invest some time in writing. I'm thinking I want to do something web or mobile-based to increase my skills in those areas, but exactly what people want and hasn't been done 1,000 times so far is eluding me. Mike. So Mike, so there's a couple of different components to this, right? So some people, first of all, you got to think about what is your motivation for starting a side project. And sometimes you can kill two birds with one stone, right? Sometimes your motivation might be, I want to learn new skills so I can get a better job. And sometimes it might be, I want to make money, or I want to be an entrepreneur and quit my job someday. Or it might be, I just want to have fun, right? So sometimes you can combine those things. And if you can, that's always good. So you're already talking about possibly doing something in the mobile space to increase your skills in those areas, which makes a lot of sense. But you also kind of want to build something that people want that will make you some money. So that makes sense as well. In general, you know, I kind of want to break this down and say, in general, like if you're just, how do I create some kind of side project or what can I work on? One good thing to do that's probably going to fulfill multiple of these possible reasons for creating a side project is to go and find some community of people, right? And go hang out in that community. It might be online, might be in person, and figure out what they do and what kind of problems do they have, right? So maybe you go to, you know, a dentist convention or whatever it is, or maybe you go and you see what professional swim instructors, you know, their forums, their message boards or whatever, and you find out that they have a scheduling problem, or they, you know, have this kind of issue, whatever it is. You know, you want to kind of figure out what their pains are and what's not being solved if you're trying to create a software solution for them, right? So the reason why I would take this approach is because you're going to actually build something for someone's pain rather than, you know, building something and then trying to find someone who needs that thing, right? You know that someone needs a thing if you're kind of integrated. And this is a lot of advice that you'll find from a lot of entrepreneurial circles on how to create a startup or something like that. So that's kind of the basic place that I would start, is because I would want to make some money from my side project, because if I'm going to spend a lot of time doing a thing, I might as well do the legwork to make sure that it's probably going to be something that I could sell that's going to potentially earn me some income. And so once you figure that out, what the pain is, you know, it's up to you how to solve it. You could use whatever technology you want. So that's where, you know, developing your skills could come into play, or even fun, like what you enjoy working on, you know, and you can solve that problem. And so that's a really good place to start. I think for most people, that's what you really should do, is try to find a pain in the world and solve that pain. Understand that pain really well, you know, do the legwork, and then solve that pain as a side project. But I understand that not everyone wants to make money, and not everyone wants to make money on their side project. I think everyone wants to make money except for like some Buddhist Zen monks. So I'm assuming that you might have other motivations that you think are more important. Although I would, you know, tell you to possibly question that, because most of the things that we do are like traced back to making money. But that's a different topic. Anyway. So if you're more about having fun or increasing your skills, then your world is pretty wide open to you. Then my answer to you is just pick something, right? Because I get all these questions, you know, and I don't mean to sound harsh here, but I get a lot of people asking me, how do I find a side project to work on? How do I pick? Well, my answer is like anything, just do something, right? Because you write a book. Create your blog, like I always say, you know, create a blog, create some YouTube videos, develop some software, create a game, do something, right? But the key here is this, right? Take it to completion. Think about how it's going to end before you begin, right? Are you going to get tired of this thing and stop doing it? Because don't even start if you're gonna do that, right? As long as most people are not unsuccessful because they failed at a thing, it's because they gave up, right? So as long as you're gonna see something through to completion, it might not be the wild success that you want, but it's going to have value. When you get 99% done with a thing, it has zero value, right? So all that time you put into it. So you know, the big thing that I would recommend to everyone who's asking, how do I start a side project, is, like I said, I gave you my prescriptive way that I would start one of finding something that will be profitable, and then you can pick from there. But my more general advice would be just pick anything and do it to completion. It doesn't really matter what it is, but you should always have some kind of a side project. You should be doing something besides, I mean, when you're working for the man, when you're going and you're doing your 9-to-5 job, you're building someone else's empire. You're not putting any bricks in your own wall. It doesn't do anything for you, right? You're getting experience maybe, and maybe you're improving your skills at your job, but you're really not building anything long-lasting for you. That if you're building a side project, it doesn't even matter what it is, right? It's at least building something. Every day you're coming home and you're expanding your empire a little bit. Maybe you're writing a book. Maybe you're building some kind of software. Maybe you're doing something, or you're just learning entrepreneurial skills that are gonna benefit you in life. So make sure you have something. And even if it's just an hour a day, pick something and do it. That's the most important thing. It doesn't really matter so much what it is. You know, if you want to make money, then yeah, it could matter. You know, you got to solve someone's pain, because people only pay for solutions to their problems, right? And the problem could be that they want to be entertained. That's a valid problem, right? But the more painful the problem is, the more people will pay for it. But yeah, do something, you know, and take it to completion. So hopefully that helps you. And for everyone who's asking about side projects, hopefully this puts that to rest. I'm tired of getting that question, because it really should be obvious at this point, right? Just do something. This is what I always say, is like, take action, do something, and that's gonna be better than nothing. Don't spend like months trying to figure out what you should do. Instead, you know, do something, and you're gonna benefit from that. And you can do something else when you're done. You know, maybe this thing doesn't work out. So what? You know, you're gonna hit a lot of failures in life, but you're never gonna hit success until you start hitting those failures. So stop delaying, stop procrastinating, stop trying to, you know, try to hit one out of the park on the first try. Don't worry about that, just do. And when you do, you'll reach the end. So hopefully that helps. Thanks for the question, Mike. And if you have a question for me, email me at john@simpleprogrammer.com, and I'll try to get a video for you. Also, don't forget to subscribe to the channel. Take care.